It was a breezy morning in the garden. The wind was blowing through the leaves of Pry's tree and making them flutter like the sails on tiny sailing boats. Pry had been looking for treasure and had found a paperclip. But when she arrived home...
Oh, my. Oh, no. Where is it? Oh, my precious green milk bottle, Top. I've been robbed. Help!
Bill and Ben, meanwhile, were playing tricks on the garden gnome and trying to make him jump.
Flop! Flop-a-dop.
But the only ones who did any jumping were Bill and Ben.
Stop! Thief!
They decided to go and find out what all the fuss was about.
Oh, Bill, Ben, you haven't seen it, have you?
Flobberdub.
Pry's lost her favourite green milk bottle, Top. It might have been blown out of her nest.
Have you seen it, that is?
Bill and Ben hadn't seen it, but they were going to do their best to find it for Pry.
Just what do you think you're doing in my house?
Ben explained that they were looking for Pry's green milk bottle top.
Well, it's not in my house.
Ben thought the bottle top might have blown inside Slow Coach's shed.
Just what do you think you're doing?
Ben explained that he was still looking for the bottle top.
Well, go and look somewhere else. I haven't got it. Go on, be off with you.
Bill and Ben had looked and looked and looked, but of the green milk bottle top, there was no sign. Bill thought that if Pry had found the bottle top when she was flying about the garden, they might have more luck finding it if they could fly too. Ben thought this was a marvellous idea, so they set to work trying to find a way to fly. Bill got ready for takeoff. Next, it was Ben's turn. Ben's invention looked a bit like the rotor of a helicopter. But the flower pot men hadn't given up hope. They decided to try again. This time, Bill's idea looks as if it might be more likely to work. He and Ben were making a sort of kite. Bill and Ben climbed onto the roof of the shed with their flying machine.
Oh, here they come again.
Slobberdop!
Woo! Woo!
Those two. Oh, if Flowerpot Men were meant to fly, they'd have been given propellers. And a pity they weren't, because they'd have flown away a long time ago.
Bill and Ben were having so much fun as they flew over the garden, they almost forgot about Pry and her milk bottle top. The next moment, they forgot about it altogether. A strong gust of wind had caught their kite and was carrying them far, far away from the garden. When Bill and Ben finally came to land, they wished they hadn't. They landed in a rubbish tip, far, far away from their garden, and their flying machine was quite broken. Then Bill noticed something.
Oh,
a green milk bottle top.
Oh,
the flower pot men had found lots and lots of milk bottle tops for Pry. But how were they ever going to get home?
Well, have those two friends of yours found my milk bottle top?
I don't think so, Pry. Well, I don't know. I haven't seen them for hours. I'm beginning to get a little worried about them.
Oh, I'm sure they'll turn up. Which is more than you can say for my milk bottle top.
Oh, yes. Lovely day. Lovely and quiet.
Slow, Coach. You haven't seen Bill and Ben, have you? Only I'm beginning to wonder where they are.
You should try to enjoy the peace and quiet while you can. While those two are around, there's always trouble. Trouble and noise and running about.
So, have you seen them?
Not since this morning. And they went flying over the garden on some sort of newfangled flying contraption.
Flying?
Yes. Over that way. They'll be back, though. Oh, yes. They'll be back.
Pry, please could you go and have a look for them? If they've flown away from the garden, they might not find their way back.
I'll do my best.
Bill and Ben, meanwhile, were still on the rubbish tip. They couldn't decide in which direction home lay, so they hadn't gone anywhere. But they were wishing they'd never invented their flying machine.
Bill, Ben, where are you? There you are. How did you get here? Well, the important thing is I've found you. And now it's time to go home. Grab a leg.
Well, well, well. It sounds like you two have had quite an adventure. So all's well that ends well.
Except I never got my milk bottle top back.
Oh.
For me? Oh, thank you. Thank you. Oh, what treasure.
Magpie thanked Bill and Ben for her new treasure, and they thanked her for bringing them home. And they both agreed that home was better than any treasure.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men.
very early, one morning at the bottom of the garden, Bill and Ben, the flower pot men, were playing Jack in the Boxes.
Oh, flubbadub.
Flubbadub.
Flubbadub. Oh, flubbadub.
As Little Weed was still fast asleep, they were playing very quietly.
Flubbadub.
Bill and Ben decided that they'd better play their game somewhere else. They didn't want to waken Weed. As they looked at her, the flowerpot men thought that such a beautiful creature as Weed should have a more beautiful place to live.
Flubbadub.
Bill decided they should ask someone what to do. They decided that Slowcoach the Tortoise might help them.
What's going on, eh? It's you. I might have known. A more beautiful place to live? Weed? What's wrong with the place as it is? I've no idea. Anyway, now I'm up. I want my breakfast.
Bill and Ben thought they'd ask the garden gnome if he had any bright ideas. But he didn't have any ideas at all. He was made of concrete.
Flubbadub!
Bill had seen something. He thought it was a piece of sky. Maybe it had floated down in the night, he said.
Flubbadub! Hi! Flubbadub!
Bill thought it was just the very thing they needed for Weed. Her very own piece of sky. Now that would smarten up her corner of the garden. Of course, it wasn't a piece of sky at all. It was a piece of mirror that had been reflecting the sky.
Oh, God, Flubber! Oh, you talk. Oh, I don't want to kill you.
Hello, you two. What are you up to? A piece of the sky. But the sky doesn't fall. And it's really, really high up. Too high up even to touch. You'll never get a peaceful Weed.
Sky!
Bill and Ben decided that if the sky was so high up, they might be able to get a piece if they climbed to the top of the fence. But the fence was very high too. Bill and Ben weren't sure how they were going to get to the top.
Flubbadub.
Bill had had an idea. He'd seen some string in the tool shed, some other bits and pieces that might help them in their hunt for a piece of sky. Slowcoach was still looking for his breakfast.
Those flowerpot men, too much energy for their own good, if you ask me.
It wasn't long before Ben found the string and Bill found a very useful-looking nail.
Flubbadub.
Bill found a piece of cloth that he thought would be just the thing for wrapping their piece of sky in.
Flubbadub.
Now they had everything they needed to collect a piece of sky. They told Slowcoach so, too.
I had a flubber look on quite a slug at you.
Sky,
I don't care about that. I just want my breakfast.
Bill and Ben told Slowcoach he'd have to hurry. If he didn't find his breakfast soon, it'd be time for lunch.
Flubbadub. Flubbadub. recoil from it all!
At last, the flowerpot men reached the top of the fence. They'd never seen so much of the world.
Flobbot! Flobbot-lob!
A flobbot-lob, huh? And a flobbot-lob, huh?
They even saw Slowcoach. He still hadn't found his breakfast. But even though they were a long way up, they still couldn't reach the sky.
Hello? What are you two doing all the way up here? Oh, the sky? You'd have to fly as high as high to touch the sky. I don't think even I could get you all the way up to the sky. Oh, all right. But I'm not making any promises, mind. Right. Grab hold of a leg each. Chocks away!
Bill and Ben were quite amazed. Everything below them seemed so small. But high as they were, they seemed to be no nearer to the sky.
Steady on down there. If you keep wriggling about like that, you're going to fall.
At last, a spot of breakfast. Oh, yes. And not before time. My tummy is rumbling like a...
Poor Slowcoach. Bill and Ben came to land right on top of his breakfast.
Oh, no! Look what you've been and gone and done now.
Hello. Have I missed something?
Only these two nitwits ruining me breakfast. That's all.
What have you two been up to?
What a funny queen!
And Bill and Ben explained how they'd been trying to catch a piece of sky to cheer up the corner of the garden where little we lived.
Oh, you are a silly pair! Why would I need this blaze cheering up? You do all the cheering up a weed would ever need.
It was still early in the day, but Bill and Ben were ready for a sleep.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben.
afternoon, the man who worked in the garden was busy in the shed. He'd been working a long time. Bill and Ben and Reed wondered what he was doing. Then the man left the shed.
Flubba-dubba-gubba-look.
You can look in the shed, Ben, but be careful. Don't let the man find you. He may not be away for long.
They might find something to mend the broken statue among the treasures hidden in the old kennel. But first they met Pry, and she was in trouble too.
I'm stuck. I found this shiny plastic thing, but it's full of sticky stuff, and I can't get it off my beak. Can you help?
Thank you.
Bill looked at Pry's sticky stuff and had an idea. He and Ben could use the sticky stuff to mend things. It might even mend the statue.
Yes, take it. I never want to see it again.
Bill and Ben hurried back to the shed, but on the way they met Scamper.
Oh, my poor gnat. My best ever nut. I've been saving this special nut, saving it for a special day. But now the shell's broken in two. What shall I do? I don't want to eat the nut. Not today. Today's not a special day. Can you mend my special nut? That's brilliant. Thank you. When it really is a special day, I'll let you watch me eat my nut.
Now Bill and Ben were in even more of a hurry, but Slowcoach was in their way.
Dearly me. Why all the hurry? I wish I could mend things. I wish I could mend the map of the garden. My map of the garden's so old, it's ripped in two. Still, if you're good at mending, why don't you mend my map of the garden?
Of course you're in a hurry. Everybody's in a hurry these days.
No time to help old friends.
No time to mend precious maps. Oh, thank you. I knew you'd see it my way. Now stick the two pieces together with your tape. Oh, you have done. Where are you rushing to?
Dead.
I'll show you the way to the shed. Now, let's look at the map. I need my glasses. Where are they?
At last, Bill got back to the shed. But where was Ben?
Oh, yes, I've seen Ben. I saw him here. Yes, I saw him here last Thursday. The next day I saw him over there. Today I saw him over there. He was talking to Tad.
It's that rose next door. Keeps going up. What a fuss. She's only lost a leaf, but I've got to get it stacked back on, or I'll never hear the end of it. Any ideas? There's a reward.
Flub it up.
If you stick Rose's leaf back, she'll give you a reward.
Flub it up, Dolly.
Please be gentle. I'm very tender and terribly ticklish. Oh, Oh, dear me.
Finished? That was quick. Oh, you seem to have done a good job. A reward? Oh, yes, you may have a reward. As you know, I have a glorious scent. Your reward is you may sniff it. Most people would love to sniff my scent. In fact, I shall do so myself. Oh, glorious.
Bill and Ben didn't want the man to catch them, so they hurried to the shed by the back way.
What have you two got there?
Why don't we... Flubba-dubba-dubba-dub.
Sticky stuff, is it? For mending things? Oh, I might be able to help. Give one end of the sticky stuff to Ben. Both of you walk backwards. Then, hold the sticky stuff with both hands. Now, try to shake it off. You can't, can you? You're stuck. I said I never know what you two will get up to next. I can see you're stuck. Stand still, then do just as I say. Bill, twist to your right.
Reed could see just how Bill and Ben had got stuck together. They did exactly as she told them, until finally... Then Bill remembered they'd still got to mend the broken statue.
Mind you don't get stuck again!
Ben didn't know he'd landed on a tube of glue. Bill had an idea. They could use the glue to mend the statue. Bill and Ben had to hide the whole time the man was working in the shed. They had to hide for a very long time.
Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. What took you so long? Never mind. Tell me tomorrow.
Reed had been waiting a long time for Bill and Ben to come back, and she was tired too. She closed her eyes, and soon she was as deeply asleep as the two flowerpot men.
Thank you.
Early one morning, Bill, Ben and Little Weed were woken by a lot of angry voices.
Tell you the truth, smells don't usually bother me. Come across all sorts as I'm recycling and turning the earth I do. But this,
it's enough to curdle my nuts, really it is. If it gets into them, my whole winter hoard will be ruined.
Oh, I'm
sorry. I don't know. Really, I can't hear that. One at a time, please.
Flubberweed.
Flubbalo.
Never think of anyone but the
please. That's enough. One at a time. Well, can't you smell it?
Weed and Bill and Ben sniffed the air.
Is that awful smell?
We thought it might have something to do with you two.
Flubber does?
Flubber way!
It certainly is a horrible smell. And I'm sure that Bill and Ben are just as anxious as you to get rid of it. Then why don't you go and see if you can find out what it is?
Bill and Ben agreed that this was a very good idea indeed. They thought it would be a bit like being detectives.
Flubber Derlock Holmes!
Flubber damn Spade!
The flowerpot men decided to follow their noses. And wish they hadn't.
Well, whatever it is, let's hope you find it soon.
Bill thought they should start looking in the potting shed.
Flubber-dubber-dead.
Ben thought the kennel would be a good place to begin. Then the same idea occurred to them both.
Slobber-dub!
Slobber-dub!
Slobber-dubber-dubber-poo!
Slobber-dubber-dubber-dub!
Bill and Ben decided that as Slowcoach wasn't at home, they'd go in and have a look around. They were detectives after all. Bill and Ben searched Slowcoach's house for the smell, but it didn't seem to be there.
Not much further.
Here we are.
Yo, what do you think you're doing here?
Flubber-dubber pong.
Are you suggesting my house is smelly?
Flubber-dubber-dub.
Go on, be off with you. Not only trespassing, but insulting the oldest member of the community as well. What is the world coming to?
Bill asked Boo if he could think of anywhere the smell might be coming from.
Flubber-dubber-bell.
Drains could be quite smelly. Never smelt a drain that smells as bad as this, though.
Oh, well. Look what the cat dragged in. I suppose this smell has got something to do with you two.
Flubber-lub.
Ben explained that they hadn't made the smell. They were trying to find it.
Right couple of clowns you are.
The stuff from the drain that covered Ben did smell rather nasty, but it wasn't the same smell as they'd all smelled earlier.
Flubber-dubber-dower.
Ben felt a lot better and less smelly after he'd had a refreshing shower.
Flubber-dubber-dub.
Flubber-dub.
Bill thought he'd heard Ben crying, but it wasn't Ben.
Flubber-blubber-boo-boo.
Flub.
Weed! Weed-a-dubber-dub.
Weed-a.
Crying? Me? No. What have I got to cry about? It's a lovely day. The sun's shining. There is a bit of a smell about, but...
A flub-a-dub?
Oh, a flub-a-dub.
Well, yes, I heard it too. It sounds like it's coming from next door.
When Bill and Ben arrived in the garden next door, they found the smell was stronger than ever.
The flub-a-dub-a-rose.
Oh, flub-a-dub-a-bubba.
Oh, I suppose you've come to gloat.
Flob?
Oh, flub-a-dub-a-dub-a.
Bill and Ben explained how they'd been looking for a bad smell and how they'd heard Rose crying.
It's me! They've put a load of manure around my roots. They said it'd help me grow. But I don't want to grow if I've got to smell this bad.
Oh, flubber-nure!
Flubber!
It's all very well for you two to laugh about it. Oh! I shall never live this down. Oh! What? Where are you going? This is so embarrassing. Roses are supposed to smell gorgeous. Not like this. No! Spades! You're not going to dig me up.
They explained that of course they weren't going to dig her up. They were going to dig the manure into the ground. That way, it will be buried together with the horrible smell.
Oh, well, get on with it. I can't stand the stench much longer. Oh, mind my roots, darling. Oh. Steady on.
Ah, flubber lovely.
I do believe you've done it. They smell quite delicious again. Thank you both. You've done a wonderful job. There's just one thing, though.
Oh, flubble.
Would you mind leaving now? You do rather clutter up my nice, tidy garden.
Flop.
Ah, don't worry about that, Snooty Rose. The garden smells lovely again. You're a very clever pair. There's no one in the world quite like... Oh, dear.
But the flowerpot men hadn't heard. They were so tired after all their hard work that they'd fallen fast asleep and were already dreaming of another day.
Bill and Ben, the flowerpot. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. The flower pot. Oh,
was a beautiful morning in the garden. The sun was shining, the birds were singing, and Bill and Ben were just waking up.
Flubberweed.
Flubberweed.
Weed?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just feeling a bit down in the dumps.
Oh, Flubberdog.
Oh, no reason, really. It's just that sometimes I wish I could get about a bit more. I mean, I know I have a happy time here sitting in the sun and drinking up the rain, but it would be nice to have a little excitement just once in a while.
That
was very nice.
Bill and Ben didn't know how to cheer up their friend Weed. They decided to go and ask for some advice. The Flowerpot Men thought they'd see if Slow Coach the Tortoise could suggest anything that might make Weed feel a little happier.
Who's out there making all that noise? No. I should have guessed. It's you two. Haven't you got anything better to do than stand outside my house shouting your heads off?
Bill and Ben explained about Weed and how she was feeling unhappy. They asked if Slow Coach could think of anything that might cheer her up.
Who do you think I am? Mr. Happy, the happiness pixie? Now clear off the pair of you. I saw that.
Oh dear, it'll never do.
Weed?
I'm sorry, I'd love to help, but I've lost one of my prickles, and I won't be able to rest until I've found it. Oh dear. No luck here. Well, if you happen to see it, give me a shout, won't you? Thank you.
Bill and Ben thought the cobweb looked beautiful. They went over to have a closer look.
I say, no! Would you two mind awfully not doing that? I'm never going to catch any flies in my web if you keep pinging it like that. I mean, you'll scare them away.
Flubberdop.
The cobweb had given Bill an idea. What if they were to play some music for Weed? That might cheer her up.
Flubberdubberdub,
they asked Whimsy if she could spin another web near Weed.
I suppose I could. I've got nothing better to do today.
Bill and Ben decided to see if they could find any other musical instruments to play for Weed.
Oh,
Oh, what's going on? And what have you done with my nut? Well, that sounds like a good idea. I'm sure a bit of music will cheer her up. But there's no need to get quite so carried away.
Bill and Ben thought they might find something musical in the potting shed. But at first, they couldn't see anything that might help them.
Flop.
Flop.
They decided they might as well look somewhere else for musical instruments.
Hey, Flubbernub!
Flubbernub!
Bill found a jug and wondered whether there might be anything musical inside. But there didn't seem to be anything in there but dust.
Flubbly!
Flubbly! Flubbernub!
Bill and Ben decided it was time for them to play for weed.
Flubbernub a weed!
Flubbernub!
Weed hadn't got any happier. She hadn't even noticed the beautiful web Whimsy had spun near the flower pots.
Flubbernub weed!
Hello, you two. What have you got there?
I know. Flubberwalk. Flubberwalk. And a flubberob. And a flubberwaddle.
Flubberizzle. Well, yes. I can see that. But why have you brought them here? What is going on?
Does this look all right?
Flobulous.
Lovely.
A flop, a flu, a flop, flu, 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 flu,
flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu, flu,
It's entertaining, in a way.
Yes, not bad. Needs rehearsal.
Thank you. That's really cheered me up. Now, let's hear it again.
A flop, a flu, a flop, flu, 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 flu,
flu,
you know, for a couple of no-good layabout wastrels, they're not half bad.
Everyone enjoyed hearing the Bill and Ben Big Time Band, but no one more than Weed, who knew that they'd done it all for her.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben.
We'll be right back.
was a beautiful morning in the garden, and Whimsy was spinning a particularly lovely web. She was quite hungry and hoping to catch something for breakfast.
Almost finished.
Bill and Ben were playing hide and seek. Ben had found a good place to hide because Bill had been looking for him for ages. Now it was Bill's turn to hide and Ben's turn to find him.
Flop.
Wait, flop and a crop.
Flop, flew, flee, flaw.
Ben saw where Bill was hiding almost at once. He decided he was going to give him a bit of a surprise. Ben certainly did scare Bill, but not as much as he scared poor Whimsy, who thought something dreadful had happened.
What was that? Oh, maybe the sky's fallen in. Oh, maybe the garden's exploded. Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
Bill admitted that Ben had given him quite a shock. Now, it was his turn to look.
A flop, flew, flee, flaw.
Ben, what are you up to?
Ben told her he was playing hide-and-seek and he didn't want Bill to know where he was.
Oh, I see. I get it. When are they going to learn that gnomes made of concrete?
I just... Who's there? Right. Oh, I might have guessed. I don't know what you've got to be so cheerful about. Oh, dear. Flubbing under.
I don't think it was thunder. I think it was something else. Wasn't it, Slowcoach?
Yes, my tummy. I think it's trying to tell me I need my breakfast. I'm going to find something for my breakfast. I hope when I return, you two will have learned some manners. Not that there's much chance of that.
Oh, dear. I wonder if it's safe to leave. Oh, what was that? Oh, I'd better stay here.
I'd better find my breakfast soon before my tummy rumbles itself to bits.
By the time Slowcoach got back, it wasn't breakfast time at all. Yes, very well, thank you. Now, if you'll allow me to get on with my breakfast...
Breakfast? Oh, Slowcoach, breakfast time was hours ago. It's nearer tea time now.
Tea time, did you say?
Oh, hello, Whoops. Yes, I did.
Oh, dear. I don't suppose you've seen Whimsy at all, have you?
No, I'm afraid not. How about you?
Oh, well, I expect she's found something better to do. I'd invited her for tea, but she hasn't turned up. Probably having much more fun somewhere else. Unless... You don't think anything could have happened to her?
Well, I don't know.
I shall have to go and look for her. I mean, anything might have happened. She may need my help. Could take quite a while, though. I'm not that fast. And then there's the birds, of course. What if they see me wiggling across the garden? My, my, they'll say. Look at that nice plump worm. Just the sort of worm I'd like for my supper. And they'd swoop down, and they'd pounce and go. It's no fun being a worm, believe me.
Perhaps Bill and Ben could look for you.
What?
Oh, would you? I'd be ever so grateful. Rub-a-dim-dim! Sorry.
Sorry? I should think you are.
From a good look at Wimpy.
Are you looking for Wimpy?
Well, she's hardly likely to be in my shell, is she?
Now be off, the pair of you, and leave me in peace. Oh, flubber-bim-dim!
Flubber-dim-dim!
Flubber!
Flubber-dim-dim!
Oh, flubber-bim-dim!
Ben said that it wasn't a spider, it was a spider's web. But Bill knew that where there were webs, there were spiders. Bill knew that spiders sometimes hide in their webs, waiting for an unsuspecting fly to land in them. When the fly moved the web, this would send a message through the web to the spider, who'd pop out to see what was going on. Bill hoped that Wimsy would pop out.
That sounds like Bill and Ben.
Bill and Ben decided that Wimsy wasn't in this web.
Help!
Oh, for what do? Idea.
You're flipping up.
Oh, it was ever so brave of them. I don't know what I'd have done if it hadn't been for them. I'd probably still be there, stuck in that pipe. And some of the noises I heard.
Well, I think we should give Bill and Ben three rousing cheers. Here we go. Hip hip!
Shh! They're asleep. They've had a busy day.
Whoops! Wimsy and Weed cheered the two brave flowerpot men, but Bill and Ben didn't hear a thing. They were both fast asleep.
Bill and Ben were flowerpot men. Bill and Ben were flowerpot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.
one morning, Bill and Ben couldn't wait to start playing the new game they'd invented the day before. They called their game Pebble Rolling, but the pebbles wouldn't roll where Bill and Ben wanted them to roll.
What a shock! Are there any more flying pebbles? What is the world coming to? I just can't believe this. I'm moving all my nuts to a new store. My old stores are in such secret places, I keep forgetting where they are. Squirrels are funny like that.
In the garden next door, Rose was watching the children who lived in her house play on the lawn.
Such charming, polite children. I hope you two will grow up to be charming and polite.
Yes, Rose.
Oh, all right. Flop. Flop. Flee.
At first, Bill thought the strange round thing might be Boo, the hedgehog.
Hop-a-lug-a-boo!
Ooh.
But Ben found there were no prickles on the strange round thing.
Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. No, I'm not a strange round thing. I'm me. Wait a minute. Don't tell me. I'm Boo. That's who I am. I'm not a strange round thing.
Bill and Ben had decided to ask Slowcoach about the strange round thing.
Rub-a-dub-a-dee, Slow-a-lo. Oh, yes. I know a lot about things. Especially strange round things. Come in.
Oh, this looks tasty. A sweet, juicy apple. Oh, I must eat more fruit.
Your strange round thing sounds to me like a sweet, juicy apple. Now, I shall now read to you all about apples. But I can't think where I've put my glasses.
What could Bill and Ben do? The strange round thing had vanished.
Last one's there and there and there and there. The shed. I shan't forget the shed. My nuts are in the shed. Got it? My nuts are in the shed. My nuts are in the shed. My nuts are in the shed.
Rubber flopperding?
No. I haven't seen a strange round thing.
Oh.
You could ask Whoops. He often sees strange things.
Oh, rubber flopperding!
A sweet, juicy apple? No, I've not seen a sweet, juicy apple. If I'd seen a sweet, juicy apple, I'd have turned it straight into food for plants. That's my job, you know. Good morning.
Oh, flub!
Hey, flub it up an apple!
Thank you, Ben. I've had that thing stuck on my beak all morning. No, it's not a sweet, juicy apple. It tasted horrid. I don't know what it'll do next.
What?
Oh!
What's that with you, look?
Oh, Dad, it's you. Careful. That round thing's dangerous.
No, it's not. It's a toy. The children in our garden, they've got lots of those round things. They play with them. They throw them about, kick them, like this. Hey.
Ooh.
It won't hurt you.
Bill had a great idea.
Flubber-dubber-ding.
Flubber.
The kicking game was much more fun than pebble rolling.
Flubber.
So that's your strange round thing. What did you do to it?
Flubber-dubber-kick.
You must have kicked it very hard, Ben.
Flub.
Ben showed Weed just how hard he had kicked the round thing.
Yeah, what a good morning's work.
Don't just stand there. Pull it out.
Oh dear. Excuse me. Is anyone there? Oh, please, excuse me. I see. Oh, thank you.
You're flubber up over the hill of a
flubber up.
If it does belong next door, send it straight back. It's nothing but trouble.
Flubber up.
Doing?
Flubber-dubber-dubber-bounding.
That, Ben, is a ball. It belongs to the children who play in my garden. Kindly leave it here and return to your own garden. I hope that will teach you two not to meddle with things you don't understand.
Yes, Rose.
All right.
Bill and Ben were glad to play their pebble rolling game again.
Excuse me, Bill, Ben. I'm feeling a bit peckish. Can you remember where I put my new store of nuts?
Half lobbed up a dead.
The shed, of course. Oh, silly me. The shed. You'd think I'd remember the shed. Oh, my mind must be playing tricks on me. I don't know what's come over me.
Bill and Ben remembered the kicking game, and they decided that pebble rolling was much, much safer.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot.
was a beautiful morning in the garden, but Slow Coach hadn't noticed. He seemed to be very cross about something.
Oh, botheration. Where did I put the wretched things? I had them last night. Oh, yes. Oh, bother. Who put that there? Oh, I did. Bish, bother, and buckets of beetles. Where are they?
Goody. Oi. Hey, Flubberlub.
Flubberlub.
Oh, indeed, I hear the pool. What's Flubber Slubberlub? What a flubber. Flubber Slubberlubberlub.
No, Bill. I don't know what the matter with Slow Coaches.
Flubber-lubber, oh, bother, oh, bother, oh, miss, bother.
Yes, I know he sounds upset, Ben. Perhaps you should go and ask him what's bothering him.
Oh, Flubber.
There, oh. What the? What's happening? Is that you two troublemakers?
Bill and Ben said they didn't want anything. They were just wondering what Slow Coach was fretting about.
I'll tell you what's wrong. I was reading a very interesting book last night. Oh, very interesting. And I must have nodded off for a moment or two. Because the next thing I know, there they are. Not there. Flub? Not who? What? My spectacles. Someone has pinched my spectacles and I can't see a thing without them.
Coach, are you all right?
It wasn't you two, was it? One of your pranks? Flub? A likely story.
I don't think it can have been Bill and Ben, Slow Coach. They were asleep all last night.
Bill said that he and Ben would find the spectacle snaffler.
Yeah. I'll believe it when I see it. And don't make too much noise about it. I'm off home.
Bill said that as the spectacles were stolen during the night, it was quite likely the thief would wait until darkness before he tried to take anything else. And when he came, Bill and Ben would be waiting.
Ooh, Flubberlob.
Flubberdan. Flubberdan. Flubberdan.
Bill reminded Ben about their plan to find the mysterious spectacle thief.
Oh, Flubberdad!
By now, Bill and Ben were beginning to wonder whether this had been such a good idea after all. But having come this far, they weren't going to give up.
Flubberdad! Flubberdizzle. Flubberdizzle!
The flowerpot men thought they might, at last, have found the thief. Bravely, they made their way towards the kennel.
Lovely sluggy sandwich.
He flubbered ooh!
Flubber sleep! What's happening? It's the middle of the night. What are you up to waking folk up?
Shh!
flubber, lobber, slobber, splacker, lobber, lobber, dob.
Looking for the person who stole Slowcoach's spectacles?
Flop.
Well, I hope you don't think I... Well, you could think again. Now, if you don't mind, I've got some sleep to catch up on.
Flubber that?
Ben didn't want to find out what was making the noise. But Bill said they had a job to do, and Ben agreed. Bill was determined they were going to see their job through to the end. Flubberdop!
Oh, it's cold. Cold.
Flubberdop, and that's your...
Oh, thank goodness someone's come at last. The man left the greenhouse door open last night and I'm freezing. You couldn't close it, could you?
But what are you two doing here? It's way past your bedtime.
What? Somebody in a hurry of ride.
Don't flop.
Frog and a proper leaf.
Looking for a thief?
Flop.
So what's he stolen then, this thief?
Slubber double X.
Slowcoach's spectacles. Well, well, well.
Flubber double?
Flubber up.
Bill and Ben thought it sounded as if the thief had come back.
Slubber up!
And that Slowcoach was struggling with him inside his house.
Rotten things! Help!
The thief hadn't been in Slowcoach's house at all. The noise was all being made by Slowcoach, who, though he was asleep, was having rather a restless night.
The young people of today! No respect!
Bill suggested that the thief might still come. So the Flowerpot Men decided to stay and watch over Slowcoach's house until he did.
But what the? Hey, what's this blocking my door? Slobber-dobber-dob. What's the big idea, eh? It's a bit early for fun and games, isn't it? Did you catch the scoundrel who pinched my glasses? Flob.
Flobber-deep.
You fell asleep while on duty, you useless pair. And talking of sleep, what a rotten night I had. Rotten! Felt almost like I'd got something stuck down my shell. Well, would you credit it? Ed Michelle all the time. Well, they must have slipped down there when I wasn't looking. That's most amusing. Oh, yes.
Oh, you poor things. All that trouble for nothing.
But Bill and Ben were too tired to answer after their night of adventure. All they wanted to do was sleep.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben.
It was a beautiful morning in the garden. The sunshine had woken Bill and Ben, and they were getting up to greet a new day.
Flubberweed-ho.
Good morning, Bill. Good morning, Ben.
Flubberweed.
And what are you two going to do today?
Flub a looking fool, and a plunk a flub, and a flub a flub, eat a flub a couple of flub.
Flub a flub. Bill and Ben couldn't think of anything they wanted to do. But Weed had an idea.
Oh, why don't we have a treasure hunt?
Flub a dub a dub, flub a dub a dub.
Flub a dub a dub a dub.
What's a treasure hunt? It's simple. Everyone goes and searches for something really interesting. And whoever finds the most interesting thing in the garden wins a prize. Why don't you go and get some of the others to play as well?
Oh, Flub.
Flub.
Slub-a-slub-a-dub.
Slub-a-dub.
What's happening? Dear, is this an emergency? Has the sky fallen in? An earthquake? Oh, it's you two. Oh, I should have known. What is it this time?
Flubber-dubber-desident.
We're not caught in it, and the flubber-dubber-rise. A treasure hunt? A prize? What do I want with a treasure hunt? Now clear off and leave me in peace.
Soon, Bill and Ben had found plenty of other contestants for the treasure hunt. There were Scamper the Squirrel, Boo the Hedgehog, Pry the Magpie...
Can I play too?
...and Whoops the Worm.
I always thought I'd make a good treasure hunter. Take after my great Uncle Willoughby, the exploring worm I do. He discovered Africa, you know. Well, that's what he told me, and I have no reason not to believe him.
Except he was a worm.
Oh.
Of course you can play Whoops. Now, are you all ready?
Flubby!
Then on your marks, get set, go!
The flower pot men thought they might find something interesting in the garden next door.
Oh,
I say, you...
Flub?
Yes, you. Are you two grubby little flower pot things? What are you up to?
Flub-a-lub-a-chedron.
Flub-a-lub.
Well, let me tell you. I am probably the most important and interesting thing in this garden.
Flub-a-lub.
Or any other garden, for that matter.
Oh,
ouch! Oh! Unhand me, you ruffians! Look what you've done to me! This is an outrage! Be off with you at once!
Flubby!
Flub?
Have they gone?
Ages ago!
Yes, I'm sure I've got just the very thing somewhere here. I can't lose.
Oh, dear. No, I wish people wouldn't creep up on me like that. What now?
Oh, bother. Oh, only a silly old pebble. Still, I'm bound to win. And I'm going to find something. Something shiny and sensational and simply splendid.
Bill and Ben searched and searched and searched, but they didn't find anything that looked like treasure. Then Bill remembered the potting shed.
Flubber-dubber-dubber.
They were bound to find something really interesting in there. As usual, the potting shed was full of interesting stuff.
Flubberdum? Flubber. Shh.
Hmm? Flub?
Flubber. Shh.
Bill thought he'd heard something. The something, whatever it was ticking very quietly.
Flubber.
Bill and Ben had never seen a clock before. But whatever it was, Bill and Ben decided that they were bound to win the prize for the most interesting thing.
Oh, Flob!
Up there, I was looking for treasure and I found it. It's horrible. Save me.
I've been searching and I still haven't found it. Hey, God, I think I have. Now, that's what I call treasure. I'll wait till the others see this. I'll win the prize hands down.
Bill and Ben had found the thing that had so scared Whoops, but they weren't at all sure what it was.
Careful, it might bite you. Look at its huge mouth. It'll have you for breakfast if you're not careful. Oh, it looks really fierce to me. Don't get too close, watch it. Oh, it's got a nasty look to it.
Boy, hey, what's all this noise? I blame the old two, you and your blooming treasure.
Look out, slow coach. It'll have your leg off given half a chance.
Oh, what will?
That.
Lettuce? It's eating lettuce. My lettuce. How dare you? That lettuce is mine, you. You. Well, what have you got to say for yourself? Go on, speak up. And what do you find so amusing, Pry?
Slow coach, that's a sandwich.
I don't care what it is, it's eating my lettuce.
Hey everyone, look what I got. My treasure's going to beat yours. It's brilliant it is, look.
Oh, flubber-dubber-dead.
Bill and Ben ran back to the potting shed for their treasure.
There, what do you make of that?
It's, very nice, Boo.
Yes, it... Oh, it's broken. Bother.
Never mind, Boo, but I think I've won. Look at this. Oh, it's very nice, Pry, but not as exciting as this.
What's that? Well, whatever it is, I think it wins first prize in the treasure hunt.
Whoopsie's treasure wins. It's delicious.
And as Slowcoach tucked into the lettuce in the sandwich, everyone agreed that the treasure hunt had been a great success.
Oh, yeah.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men.
It was a peaceful morning in the garden. But suddenly, there was a huge noise.
Oh,
my word!
Blubberdub!
What was that?
Blubberdub!
Bill and Ben rushed off to see what had happened, but on the way, they heard a sad sound.
Flubberdat! Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben.
Rubber-dubber-fumper.
I've just been... It was... now I can't.
Flubber-dubber-matter.
I was in the vegetable patch trying to eat a nut, and I started crying, and I couldn't stop.
Flubber-dubber-nut.
Well, it was an odd nut. I've never seen one like it.
Rubber-lub.
Oh, yes. Please come and look.
Bill and Ben went to help Scamper. But in another part of the garden, Boo the Hedgehog met a strange visitor.
Ow! What's that? Who are you? Well, don't just lie there. Say something. What are you doing in our garden? Pretending you can't talk, eh? Well, we'll see about that.
I started peeling the shell, and then I was crying. I don't know why. I was happy because I'd found a nut.
Flubberbob!
I warned you. I've given you a chance. If you won't speak to me, I'll just you wait. Bill, Ben, I need help. There's a strange animal lying on its back, waving its legs in the air, and, well, it knocked me down, but it won't speak. Won't even say sorry. Oh, thank you, Ben. Yes, yes, please help.
Rub-a-lub.
Flubber-dubber-dubber-dub. Never seen such a strange animal. Must have come from miles and miles away. Probably from as far as over the road.
Morning, all. I thought I saw something shiny.
It's a strange animal, Pry.
That's not an animal, Boo.
Well, if it's not an animal, what is it?
It's a sort of a speedy thing. Humans can stand on it and ride round. I've watched them from up in the sky.
Flubbered eggs.
Those aren't legs, Bill. They're wheels. It's upside down. The wheels roll along the ground.
Flubber-roll. Flubber ride!
Morning, Bill. How nice of you to visit.
What? Flubber-dubber-chup.
Flubber-dubber-Bill?
Bill seems to be all right, Ben. He's not even slightly chipped, but you really mustn't rush around so quickly, you know.
Flubber-flubber-flee.
Yes, I'm sure we'd would love to see such a speedy thing. But do take care.
What's going on?
Bill and Ben thank Garden Gnome for stopping them.
Flubber-dome.
But Gnome didn't seem interested. So they went to see Weed instead.
Oh, yes. It's a splendid speedy thing. I'm sure it'll be very useful. Bill, Ben, Weed, Whatever's the matter?
Ooh, flubberdad.
I know I shouldn't, but I was hungry, so I went to find the odd nut again.
A rubber-dubber-dutter-dry?
A nut that makes you cry? That is odd. You must take it to Slowcoach and ask him if it's safe to eat.
Oh, but a flubber-dubber-pick-a-ma-dud.
Put it on your speedy thing, then you won't have to touch it.
Oh, thank you, Weed. Be careful. Don't make yourselves cry.
You.
A knot that makes you cry. Let me have a look. Oh, it smells of... oh, dear.
Oh, it brings tears to my eyes. Oh, dear. Oh, my glasses have all messed it up. I'm sorry. I can't even see your knot. I must find a handkerchief.
But what about the odd knot?
Oh, so it's a weed. She doesn't even wear glasses.
I haven't cried like this. Oh, since I was an egg.
Oh, that's not a nut, Scamper. It's an onion.
Really? Well, I never.
Peeling onions makes everyone cry. It's the smell. So, please, take it away.
Flubber-dubber-onion?
Nobody'd want to eat Scamper's onion now, Bill. Put it on the compost heap for Whoops the Worm.
Oh, flubber-dubber-onion.
Thank you, Weed. I feel much happier. Oh, but I feel much hungrier. I must find another nut. Oh, I must.
I don't mind onions. They don't make me cry. I'm far too busy to sniff onions. Here, give it to me.
Oh, I'll soon turn your onions into food for plants.
Bill and Ben wondered what to do with the speedy thing. They decided to chase each other with it.
Oh, flubberdust!
Bill and Ben were worried about what they might find at the end of the garden. But when they got there, they found nothing.
Oh, well done, Bill and Ben.
Flubber, what did I talk about, Pry?
You brought the speedy thing back just in time.
Whoa, rubble eye.
A boy came to fetch it. He's riding it down the road. A moment later, and he'd have caught you.
Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. You two look tired.
Flubber-dubber-weed.
Bill and Ben were glad to get back to their flower pots, where there'd be no more crashes.
Flubber-lub.
Cool. Flubber-lub.
And no more tears.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men.
One morning, the garden was covered in snow and ice. Bill and Ben were looking forward to a wonderful winter's day.
Oh, be careful! It was cold last night, so the snow's become very icy. Don't try to run, just slide your feet one after the other. Well done! You're both skating!
Rubber day.
Oh!
Rubber ballet! Skating isn't easier. Not for me, it isn't. I don't know what skating is.
Rubber rubber flat of feet.
Oh, all right. I'll try. Oh, you can skate if you want. I'll stick to rolling.
Bill and Ben were thrilled they'd learned how to skate.
Hello. Have you seen the snowballs?
Flubber-dubber.
The children are having a game. They've made balls of snow. I was almost hit.
A flubber-dubber ball?
Yes, Ben. That is a snowball.
Flubbing up. Oh, what was that?
Flubber dory, Bill.
I should hope you are sorry, Bill. First skating, now snowballs. Ooh, I hate winter. Flubberdill.
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 Whoa. Flubberdorydome.
Bill and Ben were sorry they'd hit Garden Gnome. They tried to teach him to make snowballs. Next door, Tad the Frog was showing off.
I'm not scared of a bit of cold water. Oh, no. I'll jump into that pond and have a swim.
Hey?
Dear me, Tad. You're not scared of a bit of cold water, are you?
There's a frog in that pond. It's staring at me. It'll jump at me next.
Frogs do things like that.
Flubberdoo-dubberdoo.
Bill and Ben invited Garden Gnome to join their game. But he didn't seem interested. He was made of concrete.
It's all right for you two having fun. You should see what's going on next door. There's another frog. It's moved into my pond and it's sitting there staring at me.
Ooh, rubber frog.
Bill and Ben. Let's hope they chase the new frog away. We don't want two frogs in our garden, darling buds, do we?
No. I don't see why not.
Right. Let's see if he's still there.
Yes, look!
Flubberden. You're right. Two more flowerpot men.
Bill, Ben and Tad didn't know the ice on the pond was like a mirror. They were looking at reflections of themselves.
Rubber, flip them away.
Ben wanted to chase the new flowerpot men away, but Bill thought they might be friendly.
Flubberden.
You're right, Bill. Those flowerpot men won't want to stay in cold water. Right, find something to pull them out with, and I'll keep an eye on them. They've gone. But how?
In the shed, the man who works in the garden had been painting the frame of an old mirror.
Ooh, flubbered up. Hey, Rubber Lob!
How had the other flowerpot men got to the shed so quickly?
Ooh.
Hey, Robert Fred.
They wouldn't say. Ben wanted to know their names.
Flubber-dubber-dubber-dubber-dubber.
Perhaps they weren't called anything at all, so Bill and Ben gave them names.
Flubber-bub.
Now, one was called Bert, and one was called Bob.
Flubber-dubber-dubber-dubbert. Flubber-demo.
Bill and Ben had to leave Bert and Bob while they washed the paint from Ben's hands.
It's a flubber-dubber-dubber-bob.
I see. Who are you talking to in that bucket?
Flubber-lubber-flubber, then.
I never knew there were other flowerpot men.
Shh. Bert, hello.
Bert and Bob, huh?
Flubber-dubber-bird.
Yes. If I see Bert and Bob planning any more tricks, I'll let you know.
Ooh. Rub-a-dub-a-dub.
Bill wanted to play a trick on Bert and Bob. He and Ben would creep so quietly back to Tad's pond that Bert and Bob wouldn't even know they'd gone.
In all my years, I've never heard of any other flowerpot men.
Shh! Here they come now.
They look like Bill and Ben.
Well, Bert and Bob look like Bill and Ben. So that proves it was Bert and Bob. I'll follow them.
No, I haven't seen this Bert or this Bob of yours. They must still be in that bucket. But the other frogs in the pond. Look! Flubber-lubber-Bob? Flubber-lubber-Bert? Yes! How did Bert and Bob get back here without us seeing them?
Aha! Caught you at last. You've been playing tricks on Bill and Ben.
No, this is Bill and Ben.
No, it's Bert and Bob.
No, Bert and Bob are in the pond.
They can't be. Let me look. Oh, no! Another squirrel. I must hide my nuts.
What is she talking about?
I've an idea. Why don't you play a game? Bert and Bob and the other frog will want to join in.
Snowballs. Everyone likes playing snowballs. They're not joining in.
Now the ice was cracked and covered in snowballs, Bill, Ben and Tad couldn't see reflections of themselves.
The new flowerpot men have gone. And the other frog.
I expect they think snowball games are too rough. They've probably gone back to their own gardens.
Flub. Yeah, but it's strange we didn't see them go.
Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. Or are you Bert and Bob?
Bill and Ben told Weed that Bert and Bob had gone home. But thanks to Weed, they'd learned to skate. So in the end, it had been a wonderful winter's day.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Bill and Ben, the flower.
It was a beautiful spring morning in the garden. The sun shone, the birds were singing in the trees. Even Slowcoach seemed to be happy for once.
Good morning, Slowcoach.
Oh, a morning, Weed. And what a good morning it is, too. Lovely and peaceful and quiet. Shouldn't be allowed. Bill and Ben's game took them to the garden shed. Ben had knocked a cotton reel off the workbench, and when Bill came into the garden shed, poor Ben had got quite tangled up.
Flubber dead. Flubber doing.
Flubber dubber dub. Flubber dubber dub funny.
At last, with Bill's help, Ben was free.
Flubber-da-dill.
Bill had an idea. He thought they'd be able to have some fun with the thread.
Oh dear.
Bill and Ben were feeling rather mischievous as they watched Whimsy spin her web. While Ben waited by the kennel, Bill skipped over near to where Whimsy was working.
Flubber-dimsy.
Hello, Bill. You startled me.
Bill pretended he found something really interesting in the watering can.
Flubber-duh!
What is it? What have you found, Bill?
It flubber-dub an elephant.
An elephant? Oh, don't be silly, Bill. You couldn't get an elephant in there.
Hey, flubber-dung.
It hasn't gone.
A flubber-dub an elephant? Flubber-dub an elephant!
Wasn't there in the first place. It was just playing tricks on me. Naughty Bill. Ooh, that's funny. My web seems to have sunk. Wait till I tell Weed about this. Oh, dear. An unpruned rose.
Rose was giving her buds a lesson in how to be a beautiful flower, while Bill and Ben made a pretend fly out of their cotton.
In the same bed. Avoid flies like the plague. Be they black fly, green fly...
purple fly.
This is no time for silly remarks from you. Thank you very much.
Flubber-dills. Oh, flubber-lub.
What? What is it?
A flubber-fly.
Ah! It's a fly! Help! Help! Help!
Flubber-fly.
The flubber-dudden.
I suppose you think that was funny.
With poor Rose all of a fluster, Bill and Ben left the garden next door, wondering what mischief to get up to next. It didn't take them long to decide. Slowcoach was reading a very interesting book about lettuce.
I love a good book, especially one about lettuce. Oh, in fact, I can almost smell lettuce right now. Oh. The butterhead lettuce. And... look, hang on a mo. I can smell lettuce. Well. Isn't that kind? Someone has left me a lettuce leaf. Must be a bit windy today. That's funny. Poor old Slowcoach. As fast as he tried to grab the lettuce leaf, the naughty flowerpot men pulled it out of his reach. Stand still and be eaten. Come here! Halt!
At the name of the shell.
So it was you, was it?
Whimsy, Slowcoach and Tad were telling Weed about the mischief Bill and Ben had been up to.
If you'll do something about it,
I will.
Bill? Ben, you've been very, very naughty. Well, don't you think you ought to say something?
Oh. Oh, flubberdory, slubberlub. Flubberdory, Limsy. Flubberdory, Ted.
I should think so. And it won't happen again, will it?
Flub. Flub.
Now, off you go.
Flubberdory!
Look at them again.
Yeah, cheeky pair.
I think I might have an idea. Bill? Ben?
Hello?
How would you like to play a new game?
Oh, flubber-up.
Weed explained the game to them. It was called the Keeping Quiet and Still game. First, they had to sit on the ground.
And the one who can keep quietest and stillest wins the game.
Oh, flubber-lubber-lubberly.
Woohoo! Flubble-lubble fun!
3, 2, 1, go!
Oh!
Hello there!
Oh, flubber-lubber-lubber!
Slowcoach was pleased that the game seemed to have brought some peace and quiet to the garden.
Ah,
peace at last. Whimsy didn't think she'd be getting any more surprises that day either. And Rose was happily giving her buds another talking to.
And must be kept clean and dust-free at all times.
Boring!
I heard that!
The game had been going very well. Neither Bill nor Ben had spoken or moved for a very long time.
Well done, you two. You did really well. But I think it's about time for bed.
Bill and Ben wanted to know who'd won the game.
Well, you were both very good indeed. But I think the winner has to be... Gnome.
Flubber-flub.
Bill and Ben realised that Weed had played a trick on them. But they couldn't stay cross for long. After all, they'd been playing tricks on the others all morning.
Good night, Bill. Good night, Ben.
And as they settled down in their flower pots, Bill and Ben thought of all the fun they were going to have tomorrow.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men.
It was a quiet morning in the garden, and everyone was still asleep. Everyone, that is, except Slowcoach, who seemed to have something on his mind.
Come on, shake a leg. Let's be having you. Rise and shine. Come on, wake up, you lazy lumps.
Yes. What is the matter, Slowcoach?
I'll tell you what the matter is. Look at the state of this place.
It's
no more untidy than usual.
Flub. That is neither here nor there, is it? My brother Lightning's coming to stay today, and I don't want him thinking I live in a dump.
You're the flubber-dubber-dubber-doo.
What do I want you to do? Tidy it up, that's what. And sharpish.
Flubber-does? You're a flubber-doo.
Bill and Ben thought that if there was any tidying up to do, Slowcoach should do it. After all, it was his brother that was coming to stay.
But Slowcoach isn't as quick as you two. You'll have the garden looking spick and span in no time. Besides, it might be fun.
Flubber done!
Right then, you can make a start on your flower pots. They could do with a good tidy.
Bill and Ben hadn't realised how much stuff they had in their pots.
Oh, remember this? Oh, flubber daddy!
Ben!
Steady on!
Flubber dead!
What? Oh!
Oh, flubber dead, flubber huge!
Bill and Ben thought the magnifying glass was great fun.
Stop!
Slowcoach didn't.
This isn't getting the place tidy, is it? Now just put all that stuff back. I don't suppose Lightning will be spending much time in your pots. After you've done that, there's a compost heap to be dealt with, and the kettle, and the greenhouse.
Bill and Ben began to tidy the rest of the garden. They started with the compost heap.
Yeah, what's the big idea?
Whoa!
Then they tidied the kettle.
Oh, what's happening?
The drain pipe.
Flubber!
Help!
Even Thistle. At last, Bill and Ben had finished the big tidy up and went to tell Slowcoach.
Flubber done, flubber up. Flubber done, flubber up.
Not too bad, I suppose, for a couple of layabouts.
Flubber done, flubber up.
Oh, when's he coming? That's a good question. Well, I sent the invitation 20 years ago, so he should be here any minute now.
Slowcoach, my favourite brother. Good to see you.
Oh, yes. Lightning. Good to see you too. This is Bill.
The old fake hand trick. Gets him every time.
Yes. And this is Ben.
Nice to meet you too.
Slowcoach's brother Lightning thought he was very, very funny indeed.
Flubber-lub.
Bill and Ben didn't.
Flubber-lub? What's that supposed to mean?
Lightning, perhaps you'd like to meet some more of my friends.
Capital idea, particularly if they all talk daft like these two. Flobber-lob.
Slowcoach took Lightning to meet Weed.
Whoa!
Or was it the other way round?
Is this your brother, Slowcoach?
Weed meet Lightning. Lightning, Weed.
Charmed, I'm sure.
Lightning, what do you think you're doing?
Oh, I always thought water was good for plants.
I'm sorry, Weed. I've forgotten Lightning was rather keen on jokes.
Lightning played tricks on everyone.
Help!
Soon have those sharp prickles filed down.
And Slowcoach tried his best to stop him.
Now that's enough, Lightning.
Ooh, morning.
Hello. Lovely day for a spot of fishing. All I need now is a nice juicy worm. I wonder where I could find one.
Lightning even played a trick on Slowcoach. He put itching powder in his shell.
Ooh! Ah! Oh!
Oh, dear. Ah, oh, it's itching. Ah. Another one of your tricks. You. Oh, it's not funny.
It is from where I'm standing. The trouble with you, Rod, you've got no sense of humour.
By evening time, Lightning had played tricks on almost everyone in the garden.
Oh, Flobberlob!
And everyone was getting pretty well fed up with him.
Right, I think a quick bath before bedtime.
It seemed that Lightning liked to sing in his bath.
Stop! Stop that dreadful noise!
Sorry, Slowcoach, can't hear you. I'm singing.
Lightning kept on and on singing. No one could get any sleep, though it was long after their bedtime. And when eventually he did stop, he snored. He snored like thunder. He snored all through the night, so no one could get any sleep. Night turned to morning, and still Lightning snored.
He's got to go! He has got to go!
He's got to go, Slowcoach!
That's what I just said.
But how? How do we get rid of him?
Oh! I don't think we should do that, Bill.
A flubber lubber 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 and a flubber...
Ben, certainly not.
When he was little, he used to be rather nervous of... Yeah. We'd never find one big enough.
One what, Slowcoach?
A spider. A big black spider. But the only one we've got is Whimsy, and she couldn't scare a fly.
Oh, Flub would have an idea.
Bill had an idea.
Flub? What? Oh, come on, Bill. This is no time for fun and games.
Flub, 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 flub.
I give up.
Why, you absolute... Come back here and I'll give you what for. You're going to be on the receiving end of the old Lightning 1-2. Oh, no! No, no, not that, not that. Keep it away from me. Help!
Bill said that this was only a little spider. Some of the others, said Ben, were huge. That did it. Oh, Flubberdimsy.
Flubberdimsy.
Weed and Slowcoach were surprised when Lightning told them that he was leaving.
I've got to go. Bye! Help!
Bill and Ben felt rather pleased with themselves. Their plan had worked.
Bill? Ben? Lightning's gone. Flub. What did you do?
A flubble-abble-a-dazzle.
The flubble-abble-dimsy huge.
So Bill and Ben explained why Lightning had left so quickly. But they were so tired, it wasn't long before they'd all fallen into a hard-earned sleep.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.
Flower pot man.
One day, Bill and Ben wanted to ask Weed something very important.
Flubber-dubber-deed?
Yes, Bill. The sun's out, so some of the buttercup flowers may have opened.
Oh, flubber-dubber-dubber, Bill.
Why do you want to know about buttercups? Oh, I expect they'll tell me later.
Oh, yes, buttercups are special flowers.
Rub-a-dye.
Oh, no, I can't remember why they're special. Well, some days I can't even remember my own name, which is, of course...
Bill thought Slowcoach would know why buttercups are so special.
Brian?
Of course I know why buttercups are special. The famous buttercup test.
The buttercup test, Bill, tells you if you like butter. Now, hold the flower under Ben's chin.
Don't tickle him with it. Now, is the buttercup making Ben's chin shine yellow?
Oh, flub.
That means Ben does like butter. Now, you try.
Flub.
So, you both like butter. I'm not quite sure what butter is. It's something people use. It's slippy. It's slidy. And it's
yellow.
At least I think it is. Next door, Rose had a visitor.
There she is. Oh, darling Buds, isn't she beautiful?
She's all right.
Hello, what's all this then?
She's a friend of the little girl who lives in our house.
What's your love? I'm Ted.
Hello, I'm Lulu. Who are you?
I just said, I'm Ted.
Hello, I'm Lulu. Who are you?
Oh, she soon forgets, don't she? Still, I reckon Bill and Ben would like to meet our Lulu. Hello, lads. I've got a new friend for you. This is Lulu.
Oh, Flubber Lulu.
Shake hands, then.
Oh, Flubber Dill.
Hello. I'm Lulu. Who are you? I like presents. Do you?
Bill and Ben both wanted to be Lulu's very special friend.
Friend?
I think you'll have to give Lulu a present if you want to be her special friend.
Bill had an idea.
Oh, flabadello.
Dubba-dutter.
Lulu liked butter, so that was the present that Bill and Ben would give her. Bill was sure he'd find the yellow thing that people use in the shed. So that was his present.
Oh, Arben, I know of something yellow that people use. It's in that box behind you.
Oh! Here, Flubber-dutter!
Flub?
Flub?
Lulu didn't say anything about the presents. But Bill really wanted to be her special friend, so he decided to show off. Ben wanted to be Lulu's special friend too.
Ben, you've hurt your knee. Quick, rub it better.
While Ben looked after his hurt knee, Bill thought he might become Lulu's special friend if he took her away on his own.
Hello, I'm Lulu. Who are you?
Oh, I'm Slowcoach.
Lulu flabba-dutta slabba-lub.
I expect Lulu does like butter, Bill, because I've remembered that butter is something yellow that people eat.
No?
The flower garden. Yes, I suppose you might find butter growing in the vegetable garden.
You must be hungry, Lulu.
I expect you'd like a nice lettuce leaf.
But it's
It's not yellow, is it?
No. Flub. Now, Lulu, here's a delicious lettuce leaf.
Flubaloo?
Bill? You're not Lulu. Dubaloo? No, I don't know where she's gone.
Flubarabaloo!
Hello, I'm Lulu. Who are you?
I've been worrying about that all morning.
Flubber, that's Lulu.
Lulu likes butter, does she?
Flubber-a-baloo.
What is butter?
Oh, it's Flubberdale, Flubberdale Golden Yellow.
Flubberloo!
Ben made Boo promise not to tell Bill which way he and Lulu had gone.
I won't tell Bill a thing.
Flubber-a-baloo! Oh,
but what thing won't I tell Bill?
Flubber-a-loo-loo!
Lulu, that's it. Bill, I promised not to tell you that Ben had taken Lulu that way. So I won't.
Ah, flubber-den. Oh, rubber-dubber-doo.
Oh. It was flubber-flub, and it put in flubber.
Ben remembered what Weed had said when he'd hurt his knee.
Rubber-flubber-knee. Flubber-dubber-better.
Hello. I'm Lulu. I like to dance.
Oh!
Flubba-lulu!
Oh,
Flubba-lulu! Flubba-lulu! Flubba-ben-a-loo!
Oh, you're hiding from Bill, are you, Ben?
Flubba-den-a-lulu!
Yes, I've seen Ben and Lulu. They went to the back gate.
Aha! Flubber Nistle.
Flub.
Oh, thank you. I like a nice cuddle.
Oh, Flubber Den, Flubber Lou.
Bill thought he and Ben must stop hiding Lulu from each other so she could decide which of them would be her very special friend.
Hello.
Bill was showing off to Lulu again.
Oi! Listen, we got trouble. The little girl who lives in our house, now she's next door in floods of tears. Can't find her friend Lulu. I've got to take her back, lads.
Oh, Flub!
Oh, Flub! Don't be sad. Tad's right. Trying to be Lulu's special friend caused nothing but trouble between you two.
Flubba-dubba-dubba-dee.
Just forget all about her. I know. Perhaps some more buttercups have opened.
Butter! I finally remembered what butter is. It's a yellow stuff that people spread over bread. The man was eating some. Look, he's left his plate by the shed. Now you can find out if you really do like butter.
Bill and Ben didn't like butter at all. Humans might eat butter, but flower pot men don't.
So you didn't like butter after all?
Bill and Ben had found out they didn't like butter, and their new friend had gone home. But they were friends again, and their yellow buttercups brightened up Weed's day.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long.
It was a very sunny morning in the garden, and Slowcoach was feeling very hot.
Oh, hot weather? Oh, it shouldn't be allowed.
Flubbadub, Slubbadub.
Phew, Flubbadub.
Hot? I should say so.
Oh, dear. The sun's made your pots very hot, hasn't it?
I'm going to the potting shed, see if it's any cooler in there.
Someone! This is an outrage!
It sounds like Rose.
It was Rose. The man in the garden next door had bought a sprinkler, and it was spraying water everywhere, even over Rose and her buds.
It should be watered from the roots. Oh.
I don't know what you're complaining about. This is fun.
What's your Rose? Lovely jubbly this spraying lark, isn't it?
It is not lovely jubbly. We are being sprayed in a most humiliating fashion.
Oh, I thought...
I don't care what you think. Do something, and quickly.
Tad thought the best person to ask would be Weed. She'd know what to do.
I'm afraid I can't do anything, Tad.
Oh.
But I'm sure Bill and Ben would like to help.
Oh, flubber-dub. Oh, cool. Thanks, lads. Come on, then.
But when Bill and Ben reached the garden next door, they forgot all about why they were there. The sprinkler was great fun.
And just what do you think you're doing?
Flubber this! Flubber your daughter!
You're supposed to be helping me. Stop that at once, you two!
Bill and Ben did stop, but they weren't sure how to stop the sprinkler.
Flubber-lub.
Bill had a plan. But it didn't work.
That's not the way to turn the water off. You have to do it at the tap. You see that long orange thing?
Flub?
That's a hose. It goes to the tap. The water comes out of the tap, along the hose, through the sprinkler,
and all over us.
Yeah, great, isn't it?
Bill and Ben followed the hose to a tap. They tried to turn it off.
Stop! Stop it! You're turning the tap the wrong way. Oh, I never want to see that sprinkler again as long as I live.
Me neither.
Oh, spoil sports!
All that trouble and Rose hadn't even thanked them.
Flubber-dub.
Still, when they thought of all the fun they'd have with the sprinkler in their garden, they soon cheered up.
Flubber-lubber, burn!
Bill and Ben arrived back in their garden with the hose. It was very heavy and hard to pull along. And it was a long way to take it to their tap. But they thought of all the fun they'd have when the sprinkler was sprinkling them. At last, Bill and Ben had got the hose near enough to the tap for them to turn the sprinkler on. But they didn't know that the sprinkler had come off the other end of the hose. They also didn't know that the other end of the hose had ended up in Slowcoach's house.
Oh, my. What a beautiful, big, shiny thing.
Pry had seen the sprinkler. She thought it looked very nice and shiny indeed.
Oh, I wonder if Bill and Ben would help me.
Ha! A flubber-dinkler.
Bill and Ben ran off to find the sprinkler and have some more fun in the water spray.
Flubber-no-no-night!
Oh, hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. Hello! I've found the most wonderful shiny thing, but it's too heavy for me to lift. Could you two come and give me a hand?
Bill and Ben decided that if they couldn't play with the sprinkler, they might as well help Pry. Besides, they could always look for it later. So they ran to where Pry said she'd left the shiny thing.
Oh, here it is. Oh, isn't it a wonderful shiny thing?
Flubber-diny-ding.
What do you mean it's not a shiny thing? It is. It's beautifully shiny.
A flubberdinkler.
What's a sprinkler?
Flubber daughter.
Bill and Ben explain what a sprinkler was.
Hello, Flubber Dan!
And how it sprinkled water everywhere.
Well, it's not sprinkling much water at the moment, is it?
Flub.
Flub.
Oh! Flubberdoes!
Oh, flubberdoes! Pity. That would have looked lovely in my shiny thing collection.
Now Bill and Ben had found the sprinkler again, they just had to find the hose.
Oh, that potted shed's no cooler than my house when all's said and... Ah! There's a snake! It's a snake! There's a snake in my house! Help! Somebody help! An escaped snake in my house!
Flubberdub, Flubberdub.
That! There! It's a snake! Ooh, do something! It's not funny! One bite from the jaws of those things and...
A flubberdink, Flubberdub.
Well, if it isn't a snake, what is it?
A
hose, is it? Oh, and what's a hose doing in my house, I'd like to know?
It was then that Bill and Ben remembered that the tap had been running all this time.
Flubberlub. Slubberlub.
Flubberlub.
Slubberlub.
Yes, and a good day to you too. Hoses indeed. Ah! What's happening? My house! It's flooded! Ah! Whoa! This has got something to do with you two, hasn't it? You hooligans!
Flubberlub, Slubberlub.
Sorry? Sorry's not good enough. Do something!
After Bill and Ben had turned off the water and taken the sprinkler and hose back next door, they mopped up the mess they'd made in Slowcoach's house. It took them a very long time.
There! You missed a bit there. And there. And there's one there. And over there. Come on.
Flubber-lub.
An accident. You're the accidents. Now get a move on. Done quite a good job, I suppose. Now, run along and don't let me catch you playing with the water again.
Flubberdub, Flubberdub, Flub. Flubberdite, Flubberdub.
Yes, and a good night to you too, hooligans.
Oh, well, at least that water's cooled my house down nicely.
Flubberweed.
Flubberweed.
Good night, Bill. Good night, Ben.
Bill and Ben were so tired after all they'd done that day, they were fast asleep and snoring in no time at all.
Flower pot man.
It was a quiet morning in the garden, and Bill and Ben were wondering how to spend the day.
Flubberlub?
Flubberlub?
Bill! Ben! Come quick! It's a wolf!
A wolf!
Oh!
Flubberlub? A wolf is a large, dangerous animal, Ben.
There's a wolf next door.
Flubberlub! Thanks, Bill!
Oh, please be careful!
Dobadolf.
Yeah, it's the wolf. Sorry, I should be whispering.
Yeah, it's the wolf. That is his tail.
Flubberlub!
We've got to frighten him away. But who'd be brave enough?
Or stupid enough.
Flubberlub!
Oh, good luck.
Bill wanted to know why Tad was laughing.
Flubberdolly.
Oh, sorry, lads. It wasn't a wolf. It was a trick.
Ben hadn't pounced on a wolf after all. Just a piece of fur.
You see, I heard the children talking about a special day when everyone plays tricks. I thought, let's have that special day today. So I played a trick on you.
Bill had an idea.
Oh!
Flubber flicks.
If it was a day for playing tricks, Bill and Ben could play tricks too.
Flubberdome.
They'd play their first trick on Gnome. Bill wanted to hang something on his fishing rod and trick Gnome into thinking he'd finally caught a big fish.
Flubberdate.
A boot was the very thing. They could tie it to Gnome's rod with its laces. Bill had played a trick on Ben, so Ben...
What now?
Played a trick on Bill. Once the flowerpot men had tugged the boot to Gnome, Ben tied it to his fishing rod, while Bill told Gnome he'd caught a big fish.
Oh! Ooh, flubber dish!
Bill and Ben thought they'd played a great trick, and they wanted to play another one. Bill had thought of a trick to play on Slow Coach.
Flubber race?
Oh, yes. Just to prove what a wise old story it was about the tortoise beating the hare. Now, where is he?
Bill had even thought how to use the fur Tad had pretended was a wolf.
Dobadair!
He doesn't look a very lively hare. Now, where shall we race?
Flubberdine.
It's not very far. Still, let us begin.
A flub. A flub.
Three!
Woohoo! Oh, double inner!
The winner? But I've hardly moved! Ben, is that you? Pretending to be a hare? Was this all a trick?
Yeah, flub.
It's not very nice to play tricks on friends who try to be kind to you.
Bill and Ben hadn't meant to upset Slow Coach, so perhaps they wouldn't play any more tricks just yet. Perhaps they could find something to do in the cellar. Bill wanted to know why the exciting thing was tied up with string. There are all sorts of interesting things inside the basket, so Bill and Ben climbed in to take a look.
Oh,
Flubber-lubber-ding!
Suddenly, the balloon was floating into the sky. Bill and Ben were flying.
Huh?
Ooh.
Oh, flubber-dying!
Flubber-dying!
Oh, the flubber down there!
Flubber Thistle.
Bill and Ben could play a trick on Thistle.
Oh, what's that?
Help!
Bless my nuts, what's that? What's that? Oh,
oh!
Oh, where's it coming from?
Oh, my word, a call to arms. I've not heard such a sound since I was a young soldier tortoise. Fall in, take on!
No one had seen Bill and Ben in their balloon. No one knew they were playing tricks. The balloon was flying over next door's garden. Bill and Ben could get their own back on Tad.
Oh no! A huge flying frog! It's after me! Flubber toes.
Now Bill and Ben could play a trick on Rose. Ben pretended to be a giant bee.
Oh, a giant bee!
Oh, flubber dry.
Bill and Ben. Oh, they're flying. Well, fancy you two being able to fly. Is this some sort of balloon?
Flubber lollipop.
Oh, a great big lollipop. I must have a taste.
Indeed.
Have you been playing tricks again? Oh, tricks are all very well if no one gets hurt, you know. But sometimes tricks can hurt your friends. And sometimes tricks can hurt you.
Bill and Ben were very sorry if their tricks had hurt anyone.
Flubber-lub.
But they remembered what fun it had been to fly in a balloon.
Oh, flubber-lub.
So they went to sleep, happy after all.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Flower pot man.
Ben were up early one morning in the garden. They'd had a good night's sleep, and now they were ready for some fun.
Good morning, you two. Where are you off to so bright and early?
Flubberdad.
The shed? It's far too nice a day to be playing indoors.
Flubberdaday.
Bill explained that they weren't going to play in the shed. They were going to find something to play with.
Well, have fun.
Bill and Ben found lots of things in the shed. But none that they wanted to play with. Until...
Flubberding!
Bill found a piece of string.
Flubberdugador!
Bill suggested that they could have a tug of war.
Flubberdugador! Woohoo!
Ben thought this was a great idea, so they took their piece of string outside. Bill and Ben got ready for their tug of war.
A flub.
They tugged and they pulled and they heaved and they strained. Then Bill thought he'd play a trick on Ben. He let go of his end of the string. Bill ran after Ben to save him. Then Bill saw the washing up liquid bottle that had been knocked off the window ledge.
Flubberweed.
Bill and Ben decided they'd better go and see Weed.
Flubberweed.
You should never, ever drink anything when you don't know what it is, Bill. You could have done yourself a lot of harm.
Flubber did.
You'd better put it back where you found it before anyone else drinks it.
It wasn't going to be easy to get the bottle out.
Flubberdaughter.
The bucket was full of water. The washing up liquid was making lots of bubbles in the bucket of water. Bill said that Ben looked like he had a big white beard. Bill said they could play a trick on Slow Coach. They were going to pretend to be their own elderly uncles come to pay their nephews a visit.
What's going on here then, eh? Help! Hang on, what's happening? Help, I'm flying! Get me down!
Well, 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 Bill and Ben's uncles, eh?
Flubberlob.
They never mentioned you before.
Flubberlob. Flubberlob.
Oh, naughty boys? Oh, I should say they are. Why, some of the things that they've done. Where are me manners? You must come inside and take the weight off your feet. Nice cup of tea and I'll tell you all about it.
Get me down, El!
What? Oh, what's going on? Bill and Ben realised that Whoops was stuck in one of their bubbles.
Flubber-dubs!
If they didn't do something quickly, they might never see him again.
What? Oh! It wasn't their uncles at all. It was them, hooligans.
Flubber-dubs!
Dubs in the bubble!
Where are you off to in such a...
Flubber-dadoo!
Could someone explain what's going on?
Somebody, anybody, help! Flubber-pry, flubber-ding!
Flubber-dubs!
Hello, Bill. Hello, Ben.
Bill explained what they wanted Pry to do.
Oh, yes. Do you think it'll work?
Please. Help! Get me down!
Flubber-dub!
Help! Please! I don't like it up there! Flubber-dubs!
Oh, Bill! I can't bear to look.
No! Not a pretty sight, are they?
Help! The Flubber-dubs!
Flubbing!
Yes, hang on, Whoops. We're coming!
Get me down, help!
Flubber-dub.
Thanks. What happened?
What happened? I'll tell you what happened, Whoops. These two hooligans have been up to their tricks again.
You mean this was all your fault?
Flubber-dub.
I should think you are sorry for the trouble you've caused.
But they were very brave.
Oh, yes, and clever. Oh, that was a rescue and a half.
How?
Bill and Ben had a long day. Quite glad when it was time for bed.
Good night, Bill. Good night, Ben.
Flubber-dack.
Slowcoach was having a nice, relaxing bath.
Flubber-dubber-duff.
Just so long as it's not a bubble bath.
Soon everyone was asleep and dreaming of another day, but not quite so exciting as this one had been.
Bill and Ben.
one morning, bright and early, Bill and Ben woke up to see some big white clouds in the sky.
God, I've flubbered out.
A flubbered elephant.
Bill said the cloud looked like an elephant.
Flubbered elephant? flubber-doodled up bit.
Ben thought it looked more like a poodle with a trumpet.
Oh, Ben, you do say the funniest things. Anyway, I think it looks like a wheelbarrow with a tree in it.
Flubber-dee. Flubber, a deady ding.
A teddy with a rubber ring? Oh, Bill.
A flubber-a-dermidato.
Honestly, Ben.
Oh, yes. It's you, is it? I thought the garden had been invaded by laughing hyenas. What's so funny, I'd like to know?
We were playing Spot the Cloud.
Spot the Cloud? Spot the Cloud? What sort of a game's that when it's at home then, eh?
Well, you choose a cloud and then decide what it looks like.
They all look like clouds to me. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got more important things to think about. Like breakfast.
Ooh, a flubber-dowdy-down.
Bill said that he'd like a cloud of his very own.
A flubber-down.
Ben thought that was a wonderful idea.
You two are even sillier than I thought. You can't catch clouds. Now, one, a cloud floats very high in the sky. A two, clouds are made of water vapour. And three, well, you just can't catch clouds, that's all.
Flubber-down?
I'm afraid Slowcoach is right. You couldn't catch a cloud.
Flubber-dake-a-doubt.
Make a cloud?
Oh, flub! Oh, flubber-lub!
But, Bill, how are you going to make a cloud?
Flubber-den!
I think they're going to be disappointed.
Bill said they might find something to make a cloud with in the cellar. So that's where they went. There was lots of stuff in the cellar, but nothing they could make a cloud out of.
Flubber down.
So, they decided to play a game instead.
Flub! Flubber light! Flubber-den! Flubber-this!
The box was full of cotton wool. Ben thought it looked just like clouds.
Flubber-dake-a-doubt out of this.
Bill said he thought he'd be able to make a brilliant cloud with a cotton wool.
Flubber-lubber-dee!
Ben thought so too. It didn't take Bill and Ben long. Soon they'd made a really good cotton wool cloud.
Flubber-lubber-lub!
The only trouble was, it didn't float like a real cloud.
Flubbing up an idea.
Maybe, explained Bill, he could blow it into the air.
Flubber up, Burke.
Ha-ha! Bill had remembered something he'd seen in the cellar.
Flubbard!
It was a fishing rod.
Flubberdat!
It looked just like the real thing.
Flubberly!
But now they'd made the cloud.
Flubberdoo!
What were they going to do with it?
Flubber, no. Flub! Oh, flubbered idea!
Bill had another idea.
Oh, hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. Oh, what have you got there? It looks like a cloud.
Shh! Flubber-dick-a-slubber-lop.
You're going to play a trick on Slowcoach? You naughty bear! Don't worry, I won't tell.
Here, what's the big idea? Ooh, I can't compost that. It's much too hard.
Shh,
shush, I'll give you shush. This is my compost, even.
Flubber-dick-a-slubber-lub.
You're going to play a trick on Slowcoach?
Well, why didn't you say so? The flubber did.
Yes, well, just as long as you clean up after yourselves. Wouldn't want that thing stuck in me compost forever, you know.
While Bill and Ben prepared their trick, Scamper arrived with her little nephew, Scuff.
Oh, hello, Weed. You haven't seen Slowcoach, have you?
I think he's at home, Scamper.
Oh, good. He promised to look after Scuff for me this afternoon. I am going on a big nut hunt and... Oh, what's that? Slowcoach! Slowcoach!
Oh, hello, Scamper. Oh, hello there, little Scuff. Come to see your old Uncle Slowcoach for the afternoon, hey?
Slowcoach?
Something the matter, Scamper?
I don't know, Slowcoach. What's that?
That, Scamper, is a cloud. And... Oh! It's a thundercloud! It's going to chuck it down! Weed, Weed! There's a thunderstorm brewing! A terrific thunderstorm! We may very well be washed away in a flash flood. I suggest you batten down the hatches and... Hey, I don't know what you think so funny. Thunderstorms are no laughing matter. I...
You!
Kate was...
And the cloud! And it's... Oh!
Poor Slowcoach. It was all a trick.
I can see that, Weed.
You told them they couldn't catch a cloud, so they made one.
And I suppose we ought to be thankful there isn't a real storm on its way. just don't say I can't take a joke. Hooligans!
As Bill and Ben climbed into their pots, everyone agreed that this was the best joke they'd ever played. Even Slowcoach.
Flubberweed.
Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. Bill and Ben, the flower pot men. They've been playing in the garden, playing with their friends. Now they'll be sleeping in their pots all night long. Day long, fill up the flower pot.
It was a beautiful morning in the garden, and for Weed, a rather special day.
I wonder if anyone will remember.
It was her birthday.
Flubberweed.
Good morning, Bill. Good morning, Ben. And, what are you two doing today?
Flubberdis.
Flubberdad.
Flubberlub.
Flubberdub.
Flubberweed.
Flubberweed.
Oh, they've forgotten. Never mind. It wasn't that important anyway. Oh.
But Bill and Ben hadn't forgotten Weed's birthday. They were planning a special birthday surprise for her.
Oh, it's you two.
Flubberlubberweed.
What is it?
Flubberlub.
Flubberweed?
No, I haven't forgotten about Weed's birthday surprise. I'm preparing a long and elegant poem. It's called In Praise of Weed. Would you like to hear what I've got so far? Oh, she won't hear it if I recite it very quietly. Bill and Ben said they'd love to stay and listen, but they had other people to see about Weed's birthday surprise. Oh, well, you'll be able to hear it later, won't you?
Flub.
Oh, there you are, Boo. I've been looking for you. We've got some rehearsing to do.
Oh, yes, that's right. We're going to do a little dance for Weed for her birthday surprise, aren't we, Scamper?
We are. Whimsy? Ready? And a one, a two, a three.
Four, five...
Watch out! Weed's going to get quite a surprise if that's the best you can do.
All right on the night.
Ooh, I hope so.
Bill and Ben left Boo and Scamper to practice their dancing while they went to see if anyone else was preparing a surprise for Weed.
Flubberdups.
Flubberdubberweed.
Ooh, yes. I'm making Weed some grade A compost to put round her roots. She'll love that.
Bill and Ben were passing nearby the greenhouse when they heard someone laughing inside. Bill thought it might be ketchup. They went to find out.
Flubberdup?
Flubberdilly?
Oh, it's not me, Bill. I'm not laughing.
Oh, hello, lads. I've been practicing my jokes on ketchup. Gonna tell a few to Wee for her birthday surprise. All right, here's one. What'd you get if you cross a sheep with a kangaroo?
Flubberdup.
You get it.
Woolly jumper. There he goes again. Every time he gets to the punchline, he laughs so much he can't get it out.
That's because I've heard him before, so I know how funny it is.
Bill and Ben said they'd leave Tad to practice.
Flubbinator.
Oh, hello, Bill. Hello, Ben. Look what I've got for Weed's special birthday surprise.
Flubberlub.
Do you think she'll like it?
They said that they were sure she would. And if she got together with Whimsy, Weed might like it even better.
How do you mean?
Flubberlung.
Flubberday.
Pry and Whimsy were very pleased with Bill and Ben's idea. Now Weed had a beautiful birthday necklace. Now everyone was ready for Weed's birthday surprise.
Flubberdiadimsy.
Flub.
Flubberdad.
Flub.
Flubberdoops.
Flub.
Flubberdoodamper.
Flub.
Whoa! Flubberdaddy!
Flubberdaddy!
Bill and Ben realised that they'd been so busy making sure everyone else was ready for Weed's birthday surprise, they hadn't done anything themselves.
Flubber.
What could they do? Poor Weed. She thought everyone had forgotten all about her birthday.
Oh, well. It's only a silly old birthday.
It's taken me so long.
This poem is an absolute triumph.
Oh.
Happy birthday, Weed!
Oh, you remembered! Thank you!
How could we forget our own, our very own Weed? And in honour of this suspicious occasion, I have written a poem, which I shall now read.
Happy birthday, Weed! Took me weeks to compost!
Oh, thank you, Whoops. I'm sure I'll enjoy it.
Good. And now, my poem.
Wimsy and I've got something for you too, Weed.
It's a necklace.
We made it ourselves.
Oh, my. It's beautiful.
Yes, quite. Yes, nice. And now... Oh, Weed.
I've got some cracking jokes to tell you. Ready?
Oh, yes.
Oh, no.
Weed's birthday surprise was in full swing. But where were Bill and Ben?
Oh, no.
Oh, it's the way I tell them, you know.
Oh, Dad, you are funny. A one, a two, a three. Scamper, what a clever pair you are. You haven't by any chance seen Bill and Ben? I thought they might be here too.
Probably forgotten all about you, Weed. Can't keep their minds on anything for longer than a couple of minutes. Anyway, let's carry on with the proceedings. A poem for Weed. Oh, Weed! Oh, Weed!
Over there!
Oh, no.
Ooh. What is it?
What's this?
It's getting closer.
Did you think we ought to run away?
Oh, it's Bill and Ben.
Goodness gracious, Bill and Ben.
Oh, what a surprise.
Oh, Bill, Ben, you remembered my birthday. And what a birthday surprise it is.
Surprise? It was a shock and a half. Still, now I've recovered my composure, I shall read you my birthday poem. Oh, Weed, our special Weed.
Everyone sang and danced, danced and sang, until they were quite tired out. They all agreed that it was the best birthday surprise ever.
The flower pot, Bill and Ben. The flower pot, Bill and Ben. The flower pot, Bill and Ben. Potman.
It was a winter's morning in the garden, and though the snow already lay thick on the ground, even more had fallen in the night. Quite a lot of snow had fallen on Weed.
How cold I am.
The snow had even fallen on Bill and Ben.
Flubberdazing.
Yes, it is cold, isn't it? Why don't you do something to get warm? You could jump up and down and wave your arms about. That'll warm you up.
Flub?
Flub?
A flub, a dub, a flub, a lub, a flub, a lub.
Weed's idea worked, and soon they were feeling much warmer.
A flub, a lub, a flub, a lub. A flub.
I think all that jumping up and down turned the snow into ice.
Ooh, a flub of ice. Oh, flubberlippy. Flubberdide.
A slide? Oh, what fun!
Soon Bill and Ben had made their slide, and as Weed had said, it was lots of fun.
Flubber lubber, whee! Flubber lubber, whee! Oh, flub.
Then Bill and Ben decided to slide together.
Flubber whee!
Hey, what's happening? Help! They've come to get me.
Oh, dear. Ow.
Oh, I should have guessed. It's you two hooligans. What do you think you're playing at, eh?
Flubberlub, slubberlub. Flubberdied.
Well, you can go and slide somewhere else. Oh, I was having a lovely dream about lettuce in my nice, warm, cosy house. And you?
Flubberdome? Flubberdosey?
Oh, yes. Lovely and warm. It's the snow, you see.
Flubberdome? Flubberdold!
I know snow's cold, but when it covers my house, it keeps all the warmth in, you see, like an igloo.
Flibberloo?
Yes, an igloo is a house made out of snow. The Eskimos make them. Eskimos are people that live up near the North Pole, where it's cold and snowy all year round. Indigenous to the Arctic regions, the Eskimo, or Inuit, as they are sometimes known in the...
Oh, flubber-dubber-dibloo!
Bill and Ben said that they were going to build an igloo so they'd have somewhere nice and warm to sleep in too.
I haven't finished! Hooligans!
Bill and Ben went to the potting shed for some tools to help them build their igloo.
Flub-a-lub-a-flub. Oh, flub. A flub-a-diglu. Flub. Hello, lads. What's happening then, eh? A flub-a-diglu.
A flub-a-dice at home.
Making yourself somewhere nice and warm and sleeping, eh? Oh, sweet as a nut. Coming along a treat, ain't it? Just one thing, though.
Flub.
Where's the door?
Ooh. Oh. Bill and Ben hadn't made a door. Now Bill couldn't get in, and Ben couldn't get out.
Oh, flub-a-duck!
Flub-a-duck.
Snowballs!
Flubber door.
That's not a door. It's a whopping great hole, that is, you plum.
Bill said that they'd better start again.
Flubber da da den.
Right, lads, I'll leave you to it. I'm off to find a stone to break the ice on me pond. Gasping for a swim, I am.
Meanwhile, Slowcoach was feeling hungry.
I think I'll go and find a spot of lettuce for me lunch.
Flub! Floppy bowl!
Flub!
Flub!
Bill and Ben's snowhouse was coming along nicely.
Flub!
Flub!
Slowcoach didn't notice Bill and Ben's slide until it was too late.
Where am I going to find lettuce with all this snow about? Yes! Yes!
Me lunch. Slowcoach hit the wall with such a thump, Bill and Ben were sure their house was about to fall down.
Don't just stand there! Get me out!
Bill and Ben hadn't noticed that when they'd been piling the snow onto the roof, they'd unearthed some milk bottle tops. Someone did notice them as they glittered in the sun.
Oh, look at those, lovely and shiny. Hello? What's happening?
Oh, no, the sky is falling. I suppose you think that's funny. Laying a tortoise trap?
Flub-flub-a-lub!
Flibberloo!
Building an igloo?
You need to build yourself a couple of brains.
Now Bill and Ben had nowhere nice and warm to sleep in, and they were covered in snow. Bill and Ben found some old sacking in the shed. They were just the thing to brush the snow off with.
Flubber-igloo. Flubber-dice-a-dom.
I suppose the igloo would have been somewhere nice and warm to sleep. But your pots will be lovely and warm if you snuggle down with those as blankets.
Flubber-danket.
Flubber-snuggle-bugger-ug.
Weed was right. The sacks made lovely warm blankets.
Flubber-dite-dite-weed.
Flubber-dite-dite-weed.
Good night, Bill. Good night, Ben.
Soon, the flowerpot men, warm and snug as you like, were fast asleep and dreaming of another day.
Bill and Ben, the flowerpot men. Now